Okay, what I'm going to talk about first is the horse's personal space. We also call that the no-go zone. You're allowed to come closer if you like. We call it the horse's no-go zone. And what it is, in humans, we have a bubble. That's our personal space. For horses, it's more a triangle, a pie shape, like a pizza slice. And it starts at the corner, at the point of the shoulder, right here. And it comes out about 45 degrees from her shoulder, goes around her nose at about a foot, 12 inches, to the opposite shoulder. So you can kind of imagine, you can stand still for a minute, a pie slice around that. Not very nice, but this is the pizza slice. This is her personal space. Of course, she moved now, they moved too. So ideally, we stay out of this no-go zone, just as you would stay out of a person's bubble or personal space. We can't always avoid that. But that being said, we can go into it, it's just how we do it. As well, when we're facing it, when we're facing the no-go zone, it's how we do it as well. I haven't talked about energies yet. But I will say in a moment. But what we don't want to do is send impulsive pushing energy into the horse's head and neck area. That's part of her no-go zone. So her face, her neck, all the way to back here, should not be pushed. And that includes pushing from our hands, which we commonly see, right? People push a horse's head away, they push a horse's neck away. But it also includes energy being sent from our body. Our main energy comes from our core, from our belly button. That's the chi. So we can send energy into the horse's body from the chi, but not into the head and neck. So watch how I stand. I'm soft in my knees. My belly button is in, folded. Now watch this. Now it's on. This is impulsive energy pushing her away. She's being very forgiving about it. A lot of horses have actually put the head up and out, and you may still go, starting to move a little bit, because it's impulsive and rude with their no-go zone. But again, people do it all the time. They go to bridle their horse, they come in here like a predator, and their core goes, see how the head goes up and out? And they try to bridle the horse, and the horse's head goes higher and higher, and the darn horse cannot be bridled. Yeah, because you're pushing it away, you don't want that. Let the horse come to you. We can also send energy from our shoulders and hips, so same thing. If I'm standing next to her, I want to be bent in my hip. So my weight is on my outside left foot right now. I'm off. This is passive drawing energy in that banana shape right here. Now I'm on. And look what just happened. Her head went up, and she actually got a little pushy, didn't she? It wasn't bad, but she got a little pushy. So this is what I meant before about saying the behavior we see in horses is often a reflection of the behavior we see in us. So I got pushy to her, she came back into my space, and people look at that space. Her space. So no impulsive energy into the no-go zone, into the head and neck. Any body part, no hand, not with the hands, not with the core, not with the shoulder part.